I thought it would be helpful to go over some chemistry problems that are math-type problems to help you in your quizzes and exams that are upcoming. Let's go through four different ones here. First one says iron, which has an atomic symbol Fe. It has an atomic number of 26. How many protons does iron have? Well, this is the simplest type of question you can get, because always remember, the atomic number is the number of protons. That's what defines iron, is that it has 26 protons. So it's not a trick question. How many protons does iron have? Well, 26. Whoops. Because that's the atomic number. Number 2 says the atomic number of calcium is 20. So what do you know? Well, the number of protons right off the bat. It gives you the atomic number, so we know there's 20 protons. Then it says, how many electrons are in the calcium ion? Remember, an ion is a charged atom. How many electrons are in calcium with a +2 charge? Well, first thing to ask yourself is, this ion, does it have more protons or more electrons? Since it's positively charged, it must have more protons, because protons are positively charged, electrons are negatively charged. We know how many protons there are. There's 20. So how many electrons are there? Well, it's two different. It's either 18 or 22. Which one is it? Well, since there's more protons because it's positively charged, there must be 18 electrons. A little trick to do a question like this: when you're asked how many electrons there are and you have an ion, which is a charged atom, just do the math between these two numbers, but switch that sign. So instead of 20 plus 2, it's 20 minus 2. That will always give you the number of electrons. So if this ion was a negative 3 charge, you would add 3 to the atomic number to get the number of electrons. Question number 3, let's give ourselves a little more space. It says the atomic number of sodium is 11. So what do we know? Well, it has 11 protons, although it's not what it's asking us. It's asking how many valence electrons does it have? So not the number of just electrons in total, just the valence electrons. Valence electrons are in the outer shell. Sometimes we call shells orbitals or energy levels. Use the octet rule. The first shell wants 2 electrons, the second wants 8, then 8, and if we kept going, there'd be more 8s. So, this sodium atom is not charged. It has 11 protons. That's the rule with the atomic number. So since it's not charged, it must be neutral, therefore it must have 11 electrons as well. So the positives balance out the negatives for a neutral atom. So all you do is distribute the 11 electrons. How many go in the first shell? Well, a first shell can hold 2. So of the 11, we have 2. Now we have 9 left. How many in the second shell? 8. So 2 plus 8. We've used 10. We need to get to 11. So we need to use the third shell just for 1 electron. Remember, valence electrons are the number of electrons in the outer shell, which happens to be 1. So the answer here is 1. One final type of question is an isotope question. Now I'll read it. Carbon has an atomic number of 6, so what do we know right off the bat? How many protons there are? There are 6. A common isotope of carbon is carbon-13, and it's named according to its mass, atomic mass units. So in an isotope question, you'll most likely be asked how many neutrons are in the isotope, in this case, carbon-13. So a thing to remember with atoms, the mass of an atom is protons plus, we'll get that right, plus neutrons. Do we know the mass? Well, yeah, because the isotope is named according to its mass, and it's 13. That's a dash, not a negative. All right, so the mass is 13. How many protons are there? Well, we know that. It's the atomic number. It's 6 plus neutrons. So right away we can figure that out. 6 plus what equals 13? And it happens to be 7. So there's your answer. So for an isotope question, simply by subtracting the two numbers that they give you, the atomic number and the mass, we will get the number of neutrons. Hope this was helpful.